your turn, turn. And now you're gonna learn what it really feels like to miss me. Cause if you like it, then you should've put a ring on it. If you like it, then you should've put a ring on it.
We are back with the fabulous Beyoncé. Let's take a look at one of the songs you just can't get out of your head. A huge hit from a recent album, Single Ladies, Watch. That, by the way, was so big it inspired a number of parodies, and here's how Saturday Night Live paid tribute.
Single Ladies video, take two.
Playback?
Did you like that?
Oh, it was so hilarious. It was very difficult to stay focused. I told them in rehearsals, make sure I'm ahead of them so I can't see what they're doing, because I couldn't keep a straight face. And actually, Justin Timberlake came to the dressing room. It was a surprise. It wasn't planned. He came, showed up in his bodysuit, and he was like, I'm here. So it was really a great, it actually was the first parody, and it started a whole, you know, it's you go on YouTube, oh, it's thousands
it's
of people.
It's terrific.
Yeah, it's amazing.
We're back with Beyonce. By the way, her tour, the I Am Tour, World Tour, starts in Croatia this Sunday. Her movie, Obsessed, opens tomorrow. Wide. You told Vogue magazine that you called Michelle Obama after the inaugural, thank her for the opportunity, and you say she told you she was glad that her daughters had someone like you to look up to. How'd that make you feel?
You know, it's something that is the ultimate compliment. Especially right now. I have a younger sister, so I feel like I've always had someone that looked up to me. But to think that, you know, I'm responsible for so many young people sometimes is really overwhelming. But I am very conscious of that when I make decisions, and especially the older I get, you know, I don't take it for granted. And especially for beautiful children, you know, like the Obamas, I met them, and they're so young, and I can only imagine the pressure that they have to be under. But they're amazing children, and you know, I will always be aware and always try my best to be a great role model.
You like that idea, then?
I really do. You know, it used to terrify me, but now I feel like it's, you know, my music is bigger than just performing and dancing and videos. I have a voice, and I try to teach women how badly we need each other, how much we need to support each other, and how anything that you really want, you have to work for. And that's something that I feel like I can now be an example to young people.
Your husband, Jay-Z, had a lot to do with Rihanna's early career. Back in February, he said he thought everyone should support her in that mess with Chris Brown. How do you feel about that whole thing?
Well, I think she's doing a lot better. She is such a very talented woman and very smart. And I think it's really important in those times of need that people give people their privacy. So all you can do is pray and, you know, leave it up to the people around her and her to make great decisions. And she has, and she will. And, you know, I'm here to support her as well as all of my family. She's like family to me and all of Jay and all of my family.
Let's go to other things. You've got a successful clothing line. People call you a fashion icon. So I'm going to ask you about someone else. What do you think about, everyone talks about her, the way Michelle Obama dresses?
Oh, she's so chic. And she, one thing about her, she knows how to dress appropriately. Wherever she is just Her lines are always clean. She knows how to dress for her body. Very timeless. If you see her pictures years from now, they will never be out of style or out of fashion. And she's very, very classy, of course.
But she ain't buying on Rodeo Drive.
No, and that's something that she teaches us. You don't have to spend a lot of money to look like Michelle Obama, who is the fashion icon. And I think that's, you know, something that, especially right now in this time, we all need to know.
By the way, with this tour starting, Sonny, you get a little nervous?
Oh, of course, especially the first couple of shows. There's so many things that can go wrong, but you know, you just have to kind of fight through it. And right now it's getting easier. I've actually done a couple of shows in Canada, and the crowd and my reviews were all amazing. The crowd loved it. So, you know, I'm never satisfied. Every night I watch the show and I give my notes, and I always try to critique and make things better. But I still get nervous. That's why I created Sasha Fierce.
Yeah, well, Sinatra told me the same thing. Every time before he went on stage, and he said, if you don't get that,
then be
nervous.
It's true. Something is wrong. It's time to go find another job.